behind bars tonight, accused of robbing a Spartanburg County store and attacking the clerk, who ended up fighting back. News 4's Mike McCormick is on the story from our Spartanburg newsroom. Mike, any idea why the suspect picked that store?
Well, Carol, police and the clerk say the man was actually fired from the store and the clerk replaced him.
Still sore.
Bridget Jackson only has a few aches and pains, which is pretty surprising to her after what she went through at work Tuesday night.
I just couldn't dial over $2,000.
Jackson says she was getting ready to close the money tree in downtown Chesney when a man looking at lottery tickets picked the lock to the clerk's area.
Once I heard the door open, I looked and I seen, you know, this man coming at me with a knife in his hand.
Jackson says she started fighting.
Only thing I kept thinking about was I had to get home to my little girl.
She says the man pulled out a gun, led her to the safe, took a few $1,000s, and took her to a back room where he hit her in the head with the gun.
I didn't know I had that much strength until it actually happened.
She was able to slam the door to the back room and then run out a back exit to the nearby police station.
She's very lucky, very courageous young lady.
The police chief says investigators figured out that the robber was Andrew Brent Scott.
One of our officers on duty actually passed him. He was on the bicycle, passed him. He waved at the officer on his way up here to rob the place.
A judge denied bond for Scott this morning. The chief says Scott is an ex-employee from the money tree who is known to police from a previous investigation. Plus, Jackson identified him in a photo lineup, and investigators found his blood at the scene because of the struggle with Jackson.
Most people don't, especially, you know, a female, don't come out with the guy being bruised up more than the victim is.
And Bridget Jackson there says she is still not sure whether she will return to work at that money tree. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.